first thing is we need to check the factor, okay, in the sense whether the first polynomial is a factor of the second polynomial or not, okay. So now what is factor? Suppose you think you are given a number 9, okay, and this acts as a dividend, okay. If this is a dividend and you are given a divisor as 3, okay. So 3 acts as a divisor. Now you tell me, how can you say that is 3 a factor of 9 or not? So what you would do, you would divide 9, okay, by 3, okay. So then 3 threes are will be 9 and you will have a remainder 0. So when you have a remainder 0, you can say that 3 is a, what say, is 3 is a factor of 9, right? So in the same manner, here we are given two polynomials, okay. So this is called as a first polynomial and this is called as a second polynomial. So here second polynomial will be a dividend, okay, and the first polynomial will be a divisor, okay. So now what you are supposed to do is you need to check whether the first polynomial is a factor of second polynomial or not. So how do we do this? We are going to divide the second polynomial, which is nothing but dividend, by divisor, that is first polynomial. So when you divide this equation, okay, so this expression by t square minus 3, and if your remainder is 0, then you can say the first polynomial is a factor of the second polynomial. So this is how you need to solve the sum, okay. So let's do it now. So now I have 2t4, 2 into t raised to 4 plus 3t cube minus 2t square minus 9t minus 12, okay. So this is supposed to be divided by t square minus 3, okay. So what can I do now? So you know that the first term here is 2t raised to 4. So from t square to t4, you need to multiply t square with t square. And here, since you have a coefficient as 2, so you have to multiply t square with 2t square to get this term. So hence, the first term in the quotient you are going to get is 2t square. So 2t square, if you multiply by t square, you're going to get 2t raised to 4, and you have minus here and plus here. Minus and plus is minus, so 3 into t 2t square will give you minus 6t square. So you place it beneath the t square term, okay. Rest all you need not worry. So change the sign, minus and plus here, right? So this thing cancels, so this is brought down as it is here, minus t square plus 6t square. So how, what are you going to do here? So minus 2t square plus 6t square is as simple as minus 2 plus 6. Since you have a minus and plus, it's subtraction. So 6 minus 2 is 4, and hence the you'll get a positive term because the bigger number has a positive sign. So it's plus 4. So you have t square as a common variable, so you will get t square. So hence what you're going to do is you're going to write here plus 4 t square minus 90 minus 12 as it is, okay. So hope you followed this step. So next is 3 t cube. So for t square, you need to get you need to make it as 3 t cube. So what all is remaining? You have 3 and you have t, okay, which should be added extra, that is multiplied extra. So it's gonna become 3t cube. So hence you add here 3t, okay. So 3t into t square will give you 3t cube, minus and plus is going to give you minus. 3 3s are 9t, so it's here, okay, 9t. So now what you're going to do, change the sign, plus, and here also plus, okay. So now this was supposed to be minus, okay. So minus 3t cube and here minus 90 plus 90 will cancel out. So what you are left with, 4t square, and here it is minus 12. Okay, so next you can see 4t square you have, and you have only t square. So what is remaining? 4t square, you need to multiply 4 to get 4t square, right? So hence I'm going to take plus 4 here. So plus 4 into t square is 4t square, minus 3 plus 4 is minus 3 4s are 12. So here it's plus, sorry, again I'm making a mistake. Okay, so here it's minus and here it is plus, change the sign. So this and this cancels and you're having 0 as a remainder. So now, since your remainder is 0, what you can say is the first polynomial is dividing this second polynomial, okay, completely, in the sense the remainder is 0. Okay, when the remainder is 0, what we say is first polynomial, that is t square minus 3, is a factor of second polynomial. What is that? 2t raised to 4 plus 3t cube minus 2t square minus 90 minus 12. Okay, so this is how you need to solve the sum of question number 2. Okay, so now hope this is clear. Now we'll move to the next one. So I'm gonna take the question number 2. So let me quickly copy down the question number 2. Yes, what's the question number 2? Yeah, it is x square plus 3x plus 1 is first polynomial, 3x raised to 4 plus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 2x plus 2 is a second polynomial. Okay, so what is given? So this is first polynomial and this is second polynomial. Now you need to solve this sum similarly with the same procedure what we have followed in the earlier sum. So here this acts as a second polynomial is a dividend, so we're going to write it inside this. 3x raised to 4 plus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 2x plus 2. Okay, so the first polynomial will be written here, which is divisor. Okay, this is how it is. Now you see here the first term is 3x raised to 4 and you have your x square. So this x square should become 3x raised to 4. So for x squared to become 3x raised to 4, what is the short? It is falling short of 3 and another x square, right? So hence if you multiply x square with 3x square, you're going to get the term which you want. So it's 3x square. So 3 into 1 is 3, x square into x square, you'll get x raised to 4. Now the same thing will be multiplied even with this term, 3 into 3, 9, x into x square is x cube. So you're going to write it here, 9x cube plus 1 into 3x square is plus 3x square, right? Yes. Now change the sign, this gonna become minus, this gonna become minus, this gonna become minus. So now this gonna cancel, and here you can check, it's plus 5x cube minus 9x cube. It's as simple as plus 5 minus 9. Since you have different signs here, it's gonna be subtracted. 9 minus 5 is 4, and since the larger number has a sign of minus, so it's gonna become minus 4. So minus 4, what is the variable here? That is x cube, right? So hence it's minus 4x cube. Here it is minus 7x square minus 3x square. So since it is a like term, you know that minus into minus is plus, so you're going to add minus 7 minus 3 is going to become 10x square. Since the sign is same for both the terms here, it's going to become minus 10x square. Copy down the rest of the terms as it is. Okay, yes, now this need to be solved. So you can see the first term is minus 4x cube. Okay, now what you have with you is x square, right? Now x square should become minus 4x cube. Okay, so what is short here? X square, you to become x cube you need one x, and along with that you have coefficient minus 4. So minus 4x is falling short for this. So this minus 4 is taken here, minus 4x. Okay, So minus 4x into x square will become minus 4x cube. Plus into minus is minus. 4 into 3 is 12. X into x is x square. So it is minus 12 x square. Next, plus into minus is minus. 1 into 4x is 4x. So now change the sign. This gonna become plus. This gonna become plus, and this gonna become plus. So now minus 4x cube plus 4x cube will cancel out. So here you have, okay, minus 10x square plus 12x square. So again it's subtraction. You have different sign. So it is 12 minus 10. It's 2, and since the bigger number is having a positive sign, so it's plus 2x square, right? So hence I'm going to write here as 2x square. So the next one is plus 2x plus 4x. Since both are addition, so you're going to just add them, so it's gonna be 6x plus 2. Okay, sorry, I'm gonna use the same. Yes, it's plus 6x plus 2. Okay, hope this is clear. So next you see the first term you have is 2x square and here x square. So if you just take 2 here, you're going to get that same term. 2 into x square will give you 2x square. 2 into 3x is plus 6x. Plus 2 into 1 is 2. So now take minus, minus, minus. So all are going to be cancelled and you will get remainder 0. So what happens? This is the second polynomial and this is the first polynomial. So since you are getting remainder as 0, okay, you can say the first polynomial is a factor of the second polynomial. Why? Because when you divide the second polynomial by the first polynomial, the remainder is 0. Hence, you can say here, first polynomial is a factor of second polynomial. Okay, hope this is clear to you. So now we'll move on to the next problem. So in case if you have any difficulty in understanding the concept, please comment, leave a query in the comment section. I'm gonna definitely get back to you. Okay, so now it's third question. So what we have is x square plus 3x plus 1. So the divisor is same as the earlier problem. The second polynomial given is x raised to 5 minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1. Okay, so now we are going to do the same thing what we have done to other two sums earlier. So it's, I'm going to copy down the dividend side here and divisor here. Okay, so now you see x raised to 2 and first term here x raised to 5, right? Yes, oh sorry, actually the first polynomial is x cube. Okay, not so it's x cube. Okay, yeah, so here first term I have x cube, but I need x raised to 5. So what I need to do, I need to multiply with x squared. So when you multiply, what happens? X cube into x raised to 2 is nothing but x raised to 3 plus 2, which is going to give you as x raised to 5, right? So I'm going to take x square is here as a first term of a quotient. So x cube into x square is going to be x raised to 5, and here plus and plus, it's plus 3 into 1. Here when you don't have anything, it's like coefficient of 1. Okay, so 3 into 1 is 3. X into x square is x cube, so it's plus 3x cube. Okay, so plus 1 into x square, so it's plus x square. So now change the sign. This gonna become minus, this gonna become minus, this gonna become minus. So this is going to cancel as well as this is be cancelled. So now you just write down for this one. You can see what is your minus 4x cube minus 3x cube, right? So since both are of the same term, it's going to add up 7x cube. Since they are of minus sign, so you're going to get minus 7x cube. So now write down all the terms as it is. Okay, yes. Now I need in the first term minus 7x cube, but what I have here is x cube. So from x cube to minus 7x cube, what I need to do, x cube, if I multiply with minus 7, I'm going to get this term, okay, minus 7 x cube. So I'm going to take minus 7 here. Minus 7 into x cube will be minus 7 x cube. Minus into plus is minus. 7 into 3 is 21 x along with it, okay. So plus into minus is minus, 1 into 7 is 7. Now change the sign, this is going to become plus, this is going to become plus, this is going to become plus. So you'll cancel this term. So here plus 3 plus 21, so they're going to add up to 24x plus 1 plus 7 is plus 8. Okay, so now you see you cannot simplify this one. Yeah, I have copied correctly. Yes, I have made some mistake here. Okay, but still this is actually not a factor, but I have made a mistake in the the question itself. So this is supposed to be minus 3x. Okay, fine, it's not a problem. I'm going to show you once again the same problem. Okay, you can consider this as some problem. So here you can see there is no you have a remainder here. The remainder is not zero, okay. Hence the first polynomial is not a factor of the second polynomial. So coming back to the question, exact question, it is 3x plus 1. So inside I'll be having x raised to 5 minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1, okay. So now what you're gonna do, x cube, if you multiply with x square, you're going to get x raised to 5 plus and minus and plus is minus. 3 into 3x into x square is 3x cube plus 1 into x square is plus x square, right? So I'm going to change this sign. So this and this gets cancelled. Here minus 4x cube plus 3x cube, I'm going to get minus x cube, okay. So now plus 3x plus 1 will be as it is. Now you can see x cube and minus x cube means there is only a difference of minus 1 here, right? So minus 1 into x cube will give you minus x cube. Minus into plus is minus 3x into minus 1 is plus, because minus into minus is plus, 3x into 1 is 3x, right? So plus 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, correct? Yeah, now change the sign. This is going to become plus and this is going to become minus and this is going to become plus again, right? So this is going to cancel and even this is going to cancel. But here plus 1 will add up to 2. Now you can see anyhow in this case remainder is not equal to 0. So in such case what we are going to do is we are going to conclude as first polynomial is not a factor of second polynomial. Okay, yeah, hope this is clear, and any difficulty please let me know in the comment section. So keep studying, so you have ample time for your exam. I hope you practice a lot and do well in the exam. So I wish you all a happy study time. So please concentrate on your study, and please let me know any difficulty. Just leave it in a comment section. Okay, so meet you in the next video. Bye bye.